For your research writing assistance, please visit www.unitedinnovator.com. For more details, info@unitedinnovator.com. Contact at 915077031 and 934553648.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure for me to introduce our speaker today, who is going to talk us about how to write an article by Dr. Jyoti Bhatra Arora, who is a project associate at Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, Noida. Thank you for joining us, ma'am. We can start with your today's presentation. Over to you.
Thank you very much. Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Jyoti Bhatra Arora. Today I am going to speak about, I welcome you all in the session of how to write article. So let's start with that. Okay. So the very first thing is how to write article. When I say article, we divide article in two types, research article and review article. So if I talk about research, it itself is a combination of two words, that is re and search. Re means a repetition, search which is already has been done. So you have to dig your search in a different way. How you can differentiate or how you can dig that research and how you can get it a different things from already searched there. If I talk about the review article, it is a critical constructive analysis of literature in a specific field, maybe through summary or maybe through classification, through analysis, through comparison. There are the different ways how we can do that, because review article depends on already insert. Define literature. You have to read that, you have to get something summarized or something good analysis from that. So whenever you start research article, the very first thing is that you always have a broadened surface and you need to come to the central point. Means if I take about an example of IT, you have started with say networking, and networking you have wireless, you have wired networking, and from that in wireless networking you may move through the communication, you may through the transaction taken place through the this wireless communication or the advanced technology. If you are coming toward the communication or coming towards the transaction, then you have two different options. One is e-commerce, that is electronic commerce. Second is mobile commerce, that is m-commerce. Again, in mobile commerce, there are two different lines. It comes directly to the monetary level, maybe to the security level, maybe it's related to the hardware. So again, you have to specify with yourself where you want to go with, whether you want to go with the security during the transaction or security of the mobile device, or you want to go with the search with how a mobile communication take place. So you have a broadened area, you have to choose and slowly down, narrow down your circle one by one, then come to the specific central point that say that select a broad topic of your interest. And then you have to narrow down to write an effective research topic once you have learned. So I suggest only when you write any of the research article, you read the topic as a layman. Suppose, as I giving the same example, if you want to go with mobile communication, so you have to first read what is the mobile communication, what are the different protocol it use, which are the devices it use, then you come to a center point, the security, the technology they are using, then from the security, which type of security and what are the loopholes, where you want to write and how you want to write. So basically find out the difference or discrepancy between what it is and what it should be. That is, that should be the main crux of your research article. So before you write any research article, there are five questions you need to ask. Who, what, where, when, why. The very first is who. Who's represent, who are my audience? Who is going to read it? It is only the undergraduate, postgraduate or the research scholar. When I say graduate, undergraduate or the postgraduate, it also includes in a specific area or multidisciplinary. So whenever you are writing an article for a multidisciplinary, that can be open to everybody. For example, you are writing this, what is the customer of behavior or the trust of the customer on online shopping. So a management person can read it, a technological person can read it. In that case, you need to use a specific words where in briefly you have to give introduction about the trust, you have to give introduction about online transaction, you have to give introduction about what are the different sites and what are the products they can purchase. In that way you can make it. And if you're writing for a specific, like you are writing for specifically for IT person, for HR person, so there are certain terms you need not to explain, because it is understood that these are already known to these terms. Like for an IT student, if I'm going to explain about what is, say, CPU, what is ALU, it is of no use. So there you can use abbreviation and then you can proceed writing. Then is then is what symbolize is a motive, your aim, objective, why you are writing this research article. So always keep your objective in front of you. Is it for my PhD? Is it for a magazine? It is for a journal. And when you're finding out the what, you also need to make a combination with where it is going to be published. It is going to be published in say IEEE journal, it is going to be published in Scopus based, it is going to be published a UGC listed, it is going to be published in, say, after this conference or after the seminar, because that matters a lot. Like if I talk about IndoScience, Scopus Index journal, they have a certain limit. Your article should be, say, 8,000 word limit, 5,000 word limit, or to 10,000. So you need to have a different context in that. And preferably they may have the, you can say, the research based article where you have some observation, you have some data, you do some analysis on that. And if you're writing something for the conference, for the seminar or for the magazine, then the limitation of the word is very small. And we also expect the fixed type of, you can say, the viewer, the reader for that particular article. So I can summarize my article. I need not to give the complete detail in that. I can make it a crisp to serve that article to my viewer. The next point, the fourth point is when. When represent, because if I talk about to write an article, it is not a, say, you can write an article within a 15 days or 10 days. A good article needs 6 month time generally to write, because you need to read a lot and lot, whether it's a review article, whether it's a research article. So you need to review a lot and of article. Then you have to find out what are the loops or what you are going to write, how you are going to proceed, from where you're going to collect your data. You are working on your data analysis, then the final steps comes your writing. So it also should be mentioned that when you're going to publish it, and it should also be with the specific. It should not, so it may not sort happen that, like, today the world is moving to the 5G and we are talking about evolution of 4G or security or the enhancement in the 4G. No, it may also be possible our country may or may not have the technology, but the world may have. Like 5G or not fully applicable in India, but Japan has done that, USA has done that. But at that time I may not concise or limited to my own country and say that, okay, we'll limit it to the 4G because my country people know only 4G. No, research is broadened, it's global, it's a diversified. So you need to see what is moving around in your world. Then is why. It is very important question for any of the researcher, why you need to write it. It is only for the sake you need to have a list or have a in your CV that, okay, I have written that article, or you want to add a feather in your cap. When you think about to have a feather in your cap, obviously you will go to a good journal. And when you have a motive why you are writing this, like, is it going to help someone? For example, if you're writing something on the marketing strategies or HR policies during this COVID, how the company can imbibe it, what the benefit the companies or the employees may get from it. So this should be your main motive why you are going to write it. It should not so happen just to have a list in your CV you have to write it. No, you always have to think about why, what my audience will get after reading this. So once you are satisfied with answer of all these questions, narrow down your topic as a question. Why it is needed, when it is going to happen, where it can be useful, what is the use of it, and who is going to read it. And it's not necessary that after reading the article you may get what should be your topic and how you will proceed it. No, while talking, while attending marriages, while attending function, while having a lecture with your friend, with your faculties, or you are having a general talk with your friends, you get any idea. Once you have motive to write, you get any idea. Like if I talk about this corona situation has given a lot many, you can say, the heartful condition to everybody. People have lost their lives, but no doubt during this there is opportunity also. We come to know about the different technology. The schools are online. The small kids who don't know about anything, how the server works, but that they know how to work on Gmail, how to make PPT. They don't know how the cloud is working. They don't know how this going to happen, but they know how to work on it. And this in the same way, medical industry, they have an, you can say, a kind of opportunity. They have to work hard to find out the vaccine for it. They have to work hard to find different, you can say, the remedies for to protect themselves from the corona. So one side, if it is harming the human, other way it is giving an opportunity to a business, to the person. They are the different way. So you need to concise in which way you want to go, what you want to write, and what is going to be impact of it. If I'm writing something on how HR can modify or motivate their employee, modify themselves and motivate their employees, so there are the different strategies which may supersede already existing strategies, that because of corona I got it. If the situation may not have come, the people are working while coming to the office, say 9 to 5, late hours, anywhere. There is no need to tell anything about different, the software online, like we have the Google Meet, we have Zoom meeting, different software. So when you are satisfied yourself with all these 5 questions, then you think that, okay, you are capable enough to write any of the article. Article must present the core subject matter of the scholarly communication. What you want actually to communicate to your audience, it should directly come by reading your article. There are 2 important things. One is introduction part, second is the conclusion part. If we talk about that, go in very depth, but I'll just give you a crisp about that. When you're writing, generally when we read an article, we generally read the introduction and then we directly read the conclusion. Because when you are reading the introduction, you come to know the flow of article, what are the main points, whether this article would be useful to know for you or not. The second is conclusion, because conclusion generally gives a crisp of every steps, every phase that are written in within the article, and also sometimes it also describes the futuristic scope and the limitation. So you can also come to know about what are the loopholes while write in this article that give you an idea for your article. So these are basically your pathway. The very first is, you have, what is your aim of research? You have to be specific, selective, and be ready. Why? As I told you, you have to be very, very specific. As I given you the example, if you are talking about the communication, it can be the wireless, it can be wired. So the wireless to the mobile, to the mobile commerce, then the security. So you have to be specific yourself, what you want to write, in which area you want to go. But of course, you should know about how this core area is related with the other fields also. It's not only when we're talking about the communication or the commerce or the transaction taken through the mobile. Because when I'm talking about the mobile commerce, it also includes the mobile devices. It also includes some server. It also includes some security protocol. It also involves maybe the third-party software. It also involves my this apps, UPI, or my payment mode. The next point, it also includes maybe I'm making it a global. So the transaction would take place. Inter-country, intra-country, likewise. So there are the broadened area. So it's not only the one transaction, it is related to the different area. But even you don't have the deep knowledge, you should know how it is related with others, how one can impact the other. It is like a maze zip of a puzzle. That means how you fit it. If I ask you how you fit it, you have to find out the loophole where these 2 angles can be fitted. So this is how you can find out the research gap. As I mentioned earlier, you need to read a lot of research paper to find out what are the gaps. Because every research paper always have a gap that they represent as a limitation or the futuristic scope. Okay, this may also happen. has given you example of the crore. If I'm writing about the marketing strategies of the customer, I have written that, okay, the customer, those who don't even trust about online shopping, because of this corona, they don't want to go out. They are moving towards the online shopping. So it is not a trust building, but a forcefully that we are, you can say, the forced marketing strategies. Then after that, later maybe, how the trust develop because they are getting the right product. Trust may, you can say, broken because they are not getting the right product. So you need to find out in the same way what are the research gap between different research paper. What this research has done and what is the gap over here. As I am telling you about this corona, like marketing strategy, people, they have trust. But now again, the gap is there. There may be population, say 18 to 25 years people, they have more trust on the online shopping. Because of corona, now the elder people, say from after 45 to 65, they are more trusted on this online shopping. So they start learning on it, right? Now the question may come, what are the apps? Are they safe? How you can make the transaction? How you can give the notification to them? How you can provide the different information to them? Like for example, if I'm saying that, okay, I'm female, you can say work from home, nothing. So Urban Clap have made it very good. They are sending a push notification. Okay, you can use all your beauty services at your home. They will have the PPT kit, everything they have. So they are attracting me. So one research paper is talking about in journal, other research paper can talk about the age group benefit, the third can talk about the product, fourth can talk about the website, fifth can talk about say online payment. So you have to find out the research gap and find out where you can fit your maze to write your research paper. The next important point is your background study. That is, you can say, how you are going to demonstrate. What are the your contribution? In review paper, generally we analyze what other have find out. We are just analyzing and keeping it ourselves. But when I'm talking about the research, you have some data, you have some population, then you want to study it, then you have to make some data, then you have to make some get some data, then you have some analysis on that data, then you start writing on it. Sir, before you write something, or you before you want to collect data, the very first steps come is your questionnaire. When you start preparing your questionnaire, how you can prepare a question? A science teacher cannot ask a question related to literature. Similarly, a literature teacher cannot ask a question related to your science to teach the topic. In the same way, when we need to prepare a question, we should also know about the background study of that particular topic. Why I'm going to ask this question? What else I can ask them? On that basis, that you can prepare your questionnaire, and that comes under background study. That means to study a lot and lot to find out what is your topic, how it is going to impact, what are your questionnaire you can prepare. Once you are through with that, then start writing. Here I would like to mention one thing. Don't write in your mind. Write on paper and pen. The moment you get any idea, anything, you start writing. You can beautify it in later stage, but you start writing. Because believe me, mark my words, when you are starting writing on that, na, you have thousand of ideas in your mind, but when you come to in actual shape, you will be able to write only 5 lines or a paragraph, nothing more than that. So you start writing. You get an idea, you start writing on it. So when you write a research paper, there are a certain point that you can say inclusive in your pathway. What is the relevance? It should not so happen that I'm going to write something on, say, mobile commerce, but I'm giving introduction about website. Mobile commerce means related to your mobile app only. Avoidance of duplication. Don't duplicate it. Don't work it. What already has been done, that been done. You can take a reference of that. And when you are also writing, don't repeat the sentence. Say XYZ mentioned this, ABC posted the same thing. So don't. You can read and rewrite that in the same words, and in the bracket you can mention, okay, ABC, XYZ and so person mentioned the same thing. The next is feasibility. how feasible it is. My topic also, how feasible it is to start writing on that. If it may be through the collection of data, maybe through the analysis. Suppose if I want to write some research paper that may require say t-test, z-test, but I don't know anything about t-test or z-test, whether I should use the t-test, whether I should use the z-test, so it is of no use. So you have to have the knowledge of the same, and then you have to find out what is the feasibility of it. It is going to be benefited to the society or not. The next is political acceptability. Here, if I talk about the political acceptability, it can also link with your geographical acceptability. Like, suppose if you want to write some article on, say, army, arms and armature, or maybe on the corona, directly you can't blame that China has done that. Like, you must have heard about a research article there was in written in the USA, where they have mentioned that, okay, after so many of the study, they have found out, they have evidence of the same, that, okay, the Chinese company, they have, you can say, deleted their data, and then they can say, okay, we are also assuming, they are not directly blaming on that. In the same way, when you are writing anything, it should not so happen that, okay, thoughts come in your mind and you start accepting that, okay, this is my acceptance. No. When I say the political or geographical acceptance, that means you need to write, or you have to have a proper survey on that, you have to have a proper proof on that. Only then you can write it. The next point is applicability of the possible result. What is the possible result that are coming out from that research paper? What is the applicability of that? If, as I told you earlier, if I am writing something about 4G and the world is moving towards the 5G, is it going to happen, accept it? No. It is of no use. That means for the sake of writing, I am writing, but it is of no use. We need to have the globalization of that topic. We need to have a study about the diversification of that topic. How automated the topic is, how it is related, and then you come to know about what would be my result and where it can be applicable. Ethical. As I told you, one should be very much ethical while writing their research paper. One should never forget that a pen can cause lot of harm than a sword. So whatever you are writing, how the people are taking it, you have not done proper research, you have not done data analysis, but you need to write, so you put just dummy data, yes, no, and you got the analysis done. No, it is not ethical. Because when you are writing your article, obviously you will write some limitation of that, you will going to write some futuristic scope of that, other will read it out and other will find out the gap as your limitation, what you have written over there, and they start working on it. That means you have made a chain of people, those who are going in a wrong way, doing the wrong research, because you yourself has done that. So one should always make it very clear that it should be ethically accepted paper while you are writing your research. So once you have done with all the previous step, you need to organize your literature year by year, starting from the 1918, then 99, then 20, then likewise you have to write. But remember, while you are writing your literature which you are referring, it should not be later than the 5 years, because the world is, you know, growing very fast. But of course, when you are referring some theory for the customer trust, for your behavior, there are certain theory that has been developed, theory of preservation, theory of your confidence, that has been developed by 1980. So you can refer that, okay, that has been developed and we are referring to the same. But for other, if you are writing, say that ABC has done certain research in 2000, now I am referring that same research in 2021, no. Latest by last 5 years, not later than that. Like if you are in 2021, you can refer the last research paper of the 2017, not later than that. To evaluate your research, what are the gaps? Maybe you have read out a paper written in 2005, they have mentioned some gap and you want to write on that. But that gap has been filled by someone written a research paper in 2011. No. So you are referring the paper of 2005? No. So you have to evaluate your research year by year. Then you have to identify pattern and trends in the research. If the research is going in the same way, whether they have mentioned it or not. Like I was reading an article where they have mentioned about impact of women when they are on their work, when they are coming out of the maternity break. But when I start writing the paper on the same, I observe the company joining, in which they are joining, the area of interest, their family support, their financial need matters a lot. But when I combined over there, the very first things matter is their age, the second is the company joining, and the third one is the you can say the family support and the financial need. If someone is coming back for the teaching, how open it is. If someone is coming back to an say corporate world, which required you can say the late hours, traveling, different things. So the research is going only in this way, but nothing has been done whether the medical condition of that lady is allowing them to join, whether they are working or they are still working but not as a job, started their own startup business, whatever they have done. Research is not working on that. So you have to identify the pattern, and the same way you also need to find out the trends. It may so happen because of this, now the companies, they are having the crutch, they are having the daycares, so that helps a woman to join back. So now what are the impact of that? It is motivating, demotivating, benefiting, not benefiting. So you have to find out where the pattern is going on, what is the trend in the literature, and then ever you can find out what are the loophole, which is the area not touching that literature. Then you have to synthesize your literature, you have to find out the research gap, and then you are entered into the different research area. You need to recommend it. Be brave to recommend new area of research. But whenever you are writing or recommending the new research area, you should have a solid background for that. You should have a proper, you can say, proof. You can why you are recommending this research area. It may not sort of happen, a thought comes in your mind and you start writing, okay, this is a new research area, you go and work on that. No. People are writing towards the 5G, okay, now you start thinking, okay, 6G, no. Benefit, maybe health, maybe technological, maybe security, my country is allowing it or not, whether the geographical condition, political condition of my country is allowing to move towards the 5G, fully adaptable, the living standard of the people, this you can say, the way their expenses are moving, the earning, everything. So when you are through with all this point, I say welcome to writing part of your article. So I can say happy writing. But there are certain issue while which I would like to discuss over here while you are writing your paper. Some topics seems to be interesting, important, but to collect the data, to access the population, it may be very difficult, which can be one of the greatest obstacles. So while you are writing, one should know about from where I can get this data and how easily I can find out the data. Like if I'm living in a rural area and I want to write some research article on MNCs, where I have only one or two MNC in my area, so collection of that data would be difficult. Sometimes I need to pay to fill questionnaire and then I get the data. Sometimes I easily get. In the same way, if I want to know about the how the factories, they are taking care of their you can say their employees, and how benefit, what benefits they are giving. If I'm working in say urban area where there are less factories, that would be again difficult for me to collect the data. But if I'm working somewhere in the rural area or somewhere a city which is full of industry, if I'm working in say in the Gurgaon, Faridabad, I can easily get the data. So before you write, you should also have to take care of this issue. The second issue is that we can expect that interest in certain research topic will change over the time. Maybe due to funding, maybe due to political, social or economic element, or maybe due to personal factors. when I say the political, social or the economic animal, one point we have discussed about the corona, all of the sudden economy goes down. If we are talking about say setting up of the startups and different you can say the businesses, but the corona has given, you can say, shut down to everything. Now, but it again, you can say the changing the element where the people are not interested in having the business or they want to do the job. They may be moving towards the startup, work from home, right? What are the personal factors? How the mental setup of the people, those who are living or doing work from home, what impact they have while they are going to the office? When you're talking about, this is the one case we have discussed. In the same way, it can also be possible. Today I'm working, or being a female, you can say I'm unmarried, I'm working on some factor. Now I'm, after marriage, I'm moving, shifting towards the other city. So do I get the same population to work over here? To find out the research or the data analysis, to do the data analysis on that. In the same way, source of funding. Sometimes you have very good topics where you have the funding, maybe from the government, from the private industry, or from the NGOs, anywhere. Sometimes you don't have funding, but your topic is very good. Then how can you do that? Because that requires a lot and lot of money to find out, to write that paper. The second issue generally comes is your planning of the study. Depends on three factors, that is time, money, access to data. When I say that time, how much time you can devote while writing your article? How much money you can spend over there? Because as I told you, writing an article requires a lot of money of reading. When you need to read that article, you need to buy that article. Because certain articles, those are in the Scopus, say InterScience, IEEE, you have to pay. Then you can get. So anyhow, you have to spend money for that. You cannot directly get it. The same way, access of data, from where you get the data, is it you are getting it from the online libraries, online database, or you are collecting it the live. On that basis, you need to plan your study, because it is one of the major issues. Sometimes it happens for the research scholar, it is a big problem. In their 3 years, they have to get published 6 research papers in the good journal. And to write one research paper, it takes six months approximately. And then how can you manage it? But as I told you, broaden, then narrow down, then find out the research gap, and then you write. In the same time, you can write 3 different research papers by finding out the gap over there. So you can overcome this issue also. But remember, these are the important points that while you are writing any of the research paper. So here are some recommended verb that one should use while writing their you can say the research topic or the article over there. Differentiate, evaluate, conceptualize, integrate, develop, clarify, calculate, drive, establish, suggest, compile, consolidate, appraise, recommend. So these are certain important recommended verbs that one can use it. But as you know, the every coin has a 2 different sides. The second side of is that there are certain verbs one should avoid, like understand, know, explore, investigate, examine, discuss. This can be used as an aim, but not the objective of your, you can say, the research. We understand this, we know this. If everybody knows this, there is no need to write the research article. So these are certain words that we should avoid while writing. In the last, I can say only one thing. While you are writing your research article, be ethical, be honest, and always keep your eyes, ear and brain open. Be open to accept the loophole in your paper. Because when we are doing any work, the unconscious mind of myself knows about what I am lacking, what this paper lacking behind. So that becomes your, you can say, the limitation. Accept it and write it as your limitation. The second is futuristic scope. It should not so happen that while you are writing the research article or any of the article, it started and then ended. No. It should always be open to the next step. what would be the next step? How can we proceed further? Like if I give you an example, when we have first year, we have been taught about architect of the computer. Then in the second year, we have taught about the programming language, general, third level or the advanced level. Then at the third level, we have advanced level, advanced Java, J2E, XML, Oracle. So this is how step by step we go. It not happen that in the first year you have the Oracle, then when you or the in the second year you have the architect. No, when you have studied about the architect, that comes what's next. I know about the architect of the system. I know about the processor. I know about the memory, how it works, how buses are working. No, and what would be the next step? Next step is that how you operate it, how your operating system is going to work, how your programming language you develop, you write, and then you work on it. Then the third step is that then you have know about that. Next step is to write an application. You prepare a software, you write an applications. So this is how we work. So I thank you everyone to in this session. In case of you have any query or any question, you're most welcome. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your valuable inputs that were presented in the guest lecture, ma'am.
Thank you for receiving
regular updates about IFERP guest lecturer series, kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel and turn the notification on. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thanks.